Soil Conservation Service came on board during the construction phase of this project after a lengthy design and informative reporting phase. Previously a restaurant that was on this premises that was on Crown land, the restaurant became unstable, fell in the water, and as a result of that, Crown Lands had to do some remediation works to stabilise the foreshore and provide amenity for the public. Soil Conservation Service has constructed a sandbag revetment wall here in conjunction with a groyne structure at the end of it that's looking to provide temporary stabilisation to the foreshore and also provide public amenity to the area.
My name is Emma Belford, I'm an environmental officer. My role in this project was to assist with the build and on-site supervision. The project at Pelican involved laying about 460 geo-fabric sand containers with a 60-tonne crane and then a further 23 larger sand containers with a 100-tonne crane. After excavation, these sand containers were laid over sheets of geo-fabric. The project at Pelican was very challenging. Some of the challenges we faced were really strong currents and eddies. The current could move from 6 to 7 metres per second on some days. So this gave us a really narrow time frame to actually construct. Working with different contractors of various professions and coordinating them was very challenging. We overcame this by having a toolbox meeting each morning and discussing what we had achieved the previous day and then setting out goals for the day ahead.
One of the challenges that we faced was that the original design had to constantly change through the project due to the constantly changing site. The site was changing due to the foreshore retreating from where it initially was during the construction phase. This influenced construction methodology that had to be amended on the go and approved by the engineers.
My role here was site supervisor. Tom and Wayne took sort of a care of administration. I was taking care of the work in the water and liaising with the senior management, engineers and Crown Lands on what we're going to do with the works. Well, there was three divers here. There was one guy just with communications and he was relaying messages, signals back to the crane driver, and the other one's just making sure their hoses, the umbilical cords, not getting caught on stuff, and they just rotate after a period of time.
So an example of the challenges that were faced by the dive crew was to spread the geofabric, which underlays the entire structure. To do this, we had to come up with an innovative solution, which included having a prefabricated metal bar that was attached to the crane, which then drew the geofabric out. Now we've provided a better amenity for the community, which ties in better with the natural landscape as opposed to the former sheet piling that was here.
Over the course of 4 months, Soil Conservation has been able to turn this unusable space into a safe place for the community to come and enjoy.